things. We got a call from a gentleman here who loves a Land Rover. He said he ran out of fuel, but when I got here, it had like 30 miles in it to go. We put about 10 to 15 bucks in it, and it's up to about 45 to 50 miles to go. It just won't start. I don't know if there's like a safety thing switched in it or not. We got Moose towing out here to tow it. Maybe it doesn't have enough fuel in it. I don't know, but it should. Out here and us. I'm not sure exactly what's going on with this Range Rover. It just won't start. He said he ran out of gas, but it, you know, when I got here, it had 30 miles in it to go. And we put another, like, 10, 15 bucks in it, and it has, like, 45, 50 miles in it to go, but it just won't start. Okay, so we got the truck. We got it loaded. Still couldn't get it started. Not sure if it's a safety measure with this thing or what. It's a Range Rover, Land Rover, so no telling. But no matter what, we can't leave the vehicle sitting here on the side of the road, so that's why we had to call the tow trucks to at least get it off the road. We're going to go down here to Ho-Chunk, because that's where the gentleman's at. It's open.
Do you think through my insurance, the roadside will be cheaper to tow it?
I don't know, but I would just get it from here down to there. If you want them to unload it down there and then have your roadside come and get it, then that would probably be cheaper to get it to Madison, yeah.
Okay.
But from here to down to the gas station, yeah.
For now, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just let him know what you want to do first, you know.
Okay. Sweet. Thank you.
We're going to turn our lights off here. We're right between two big tow trucks. So we don't really need our lights on. We're going to go down here to Ho-Chunk and figure out what the game plan is. I'm not sure if he's going to have these guys tow it to Madison or not, to the dealership. Because that's where it really needs to go, is to a dealership, especially if the fuel pump's burned out of it. That's why you're not supposed to let your vehicles run out of fuel, is because the fuel pump in them can just burn up immediately. Here we go. I mean, the customer keeps asking if I put more gas in it, will it start? Probably not, but I said it was worth a try. I mean, what's it gonna hurt, you know, to be honest? Yeah, they're going to pull up at the pump and put some fuel in it, and we'll see if it'll start. I'm going to park up here. Out of everybody's way. Don't worry, we'll go back there. We're going to stay on this one for a little bit yet. I'll take the phone with me.
and you guys.
That's what I said, Tony. It's a lot easier than, you know, if it does start, that's a lot easier than hauling back and forth a couple bucks at a time. You know, I mean, it couldn't hurt to try, you know, to see if it's just, you know, that far out of fuel, but.
Last couple times this problem ever happened, it was the fuel pump in these vehicles burned up.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's why you're not supposed to run them out of fuel at all. The fuel pump, if you get them dry, once they get wet from fuel for the very first time, they're supposed to always stay wet. And if they dry out, they go bad. I mean, they go bad just that quick. Snap your fingers. Yeah.
I don't know what I was thinking, but...
Did you, when the vehicle stopped, did you try to start it a bunch of times again? Yeah, that probably is what dry. If it is the fuel pump, that could have dried out the fuel pump right there, trying to, you know, the air sucking into the pump, you know, dry it out. Yeah.
How much do you think it would be costing?
I have no idea on these vehicles. I don't do that kind of work.
What normally?
On my truck, it was like $350 on my black truck when I had it done. But that's an easy vehicle because right. It's on the side. They just take two straps off, lower it down, take it out, and put a new one in. It's pretty simple. I don't know about this thing. I mean, generally, you know, the more expensive the vehicle, the more expensive the parts and stuff's going to be. Yeah. Let's cross our fingers, say a little prayer on it. Steve doing the same thing. See what's going on. I think they're just gonna drop it right over here. And then he's gonna have, because he works here at the casino, and that's exactly where we are right now, is at the casino. So, you know, he can leave the vehicle here. But yeah, I guess, you know, putting more fuel in it, you know, didn't do the trick. So, yeah. Well, I'm going to get out of here. These guys got it handled from here. They're probably going to tow it down to Madison, Diaz Vault, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.